Have you heard of Chat GPT? Good, because you can forget about that, because Canva has its own version called Magic Write. And I have to say, if you're a content creator like me, it's so much better. You will never have to sit and stare at a blank piece of paper waiting for inspiration. Canva's Magic Write is a simple but very powerful writing tool that will allow you to create high-quality documents in seconds. So in this video, I'm going to share with you everything you need to know about Magic Write so far and how to use Magic Write to create content in seconds like this Instagram carousel. Also, before you rush headlong into publishing that book that's been on the back burner for months, please stay tuned because I've got some quick but very important points to share with you regarding AI and copyright. Okay, let's dive into Canva.
Let me first answer a couple of potential questions you might have. So, who can use Magic Write? Essentially, everybody can use Magic Write apart from people who use Canva for education. If you have a free Canva account, you have a total of 25 queries, and that doesn't reset every month or every year, it is in total. If you have Canva Pro, you have up to 75 queries per month. Each query is limited to 500 words. Since Magic Write's in open beta at the moment, it's only available in 5 languages: English, French, Spanish, Portuguese, and Indonesian. But I'm fairly certain that will change and more languages will be added in time. There are some very important copyright issues that I need to share with you at the end of this video, but for now, let's dive into the fun stuff. Currently, there's only one way to access Magic Write, and that is via Canva Docs. You'll find Canva Docs from your homepage by clicking on this little button here or clicking on the thumbnail image. This will open up a blank document in the Design Editor. At the top, you'll find a handy toolbar of text editing features. A blank document will have an example of a heading at the top and a little bit of body text. You don't have to delete this text before you get started, just start typing. The text will be formatted according to the brand kit you're currently in. So I'm sure most of you will just have one brand kit, which will be your own. But if you're a virtual assistant or a freelancer and you work with different clients, you can easily change your brand kit from within the Design Editor. Click on the little downward arrow to access the text drop-down menu. Find where your brand kit is located. Click on this little downward arrow to change your brand kit. And you can do that directly within the Design Editor. Of course, you're free to use any of the fonts in the usual way. You have no restrictions, unless, of course, there's a little crown icon next to a text, and that means that's a pro font. To begin adding magic to your Canva doc, just hover your cursor over this little plus icon and click on it, and that will open up a new menu of magical writing options. And here is where you will find Magic Write. But before we get started, I do need to show you how to use the other features, because you'll need to know how to use them so that you can transform your document into something like these beautiful templates. At the top of the menu, you can quickly add a heading, a subheading, and some body text. Underneath, you have the option to add a table quickly into your Canva doc. Use your cursor to select however many rows and columns you want to add. Add text by placing your cursor within a cell, clicking on it, and then start typing. If you want to learn more about how to create beautiful tables in a Canva document, make sure you watch this video. I will leave the link in the description box underneath. Next in the menu, you will find data charts, and you have 3 sorts. You have pie charts, bar charts, and line charts. just click on one of the icons to add it to your document. Doing so will bring up a data menu on the left-hand side of your screen, in which you'll be able to add all the data that you need. Customizing the data within a chart is incredibly easy. In fact, it's now possible to upload data into a Canva chart using a CSV file. Going back to the document, underneath the data charts, you will find a tool which will enable you to embed a link from another website and even a link to a template in Canva. Click on Embed. Now copy and paste the link into this box provided. So, for example, to add a link to a YouTube video, paste the link into this box, hit Enter, and your YouTube thumbnail image will appear in your document. Now just double-click the thumbnail image to start the video. It's also possible to share links to Canva templates in the same way. So I'm just going to get rid of my video. And from my Canva homepage, I'm going to select the document I want to share, selecting the link to share it. So in my case, view only link. I'm going to copy that link. I'm going to go back into my Canva doc. Find the embed option again, click on it, and then paste that link into the space provided, and then just hit enter. And there it is. I need to double click on the thumbnail image to activate it, but after that I can scroll through the different pages and even play any videos contained within it. Underneath embed, you'll find a handy little timer, which you can use if you're working in a Canva doc with a team and you have, say, a 3-minute window to have a chat with your team. Just click on the start button to start the countdown timer, keep you on track. Underneath the timer, you can add a design. Now, this is really handy and it would look lovely at the top of a blog post or an article. Click on design and Canva will magically present you with a bunch of beautiful pre-formatted templates from within the design editor. So you can use any of these in your doc. Select the template you like the look of. Unfortunately, at the current time, you can't do a quick rebrand using your brand kit because they're not available at the moment. So as a quick workaround, you can use the styles option and recent designs to quickly add your own brand fonts and colours to your template. Alternatively, of course, if you don't like any of the templates, you can design your own in the usual way. Once you're finished, give your banner a name, click on save, and Canva will magically add it to your Canva doc. Now let's have a look at Magic Write. Click on the plus icon again and select Magic Write. Now type in your search query using 5 or more words to describe what you want. You can write absolutely anything, so have a play first of all and see what you can do. If you're a little bit stuck, you can try an example. If you don't like that, try another one. Once you've typed your search query, just hit enter and wait for the magic to happen. And here are the results of my search query. The search query will form a heading at the top. So write a new blog outline for a product launch, and underneath is the content that Magic Write has just generated. So you can start to see how fantastic this is for content creators. Now all you need to do is start fleshing out this content using all the features that I've just shown you. There are so many ways Magic Write will help you brainstorm ideas and come up with content suggestions. You may have noticed at the start of this video that I used Magic Write to help me create this Instagram carousel. I started by typing my search query into Magic Write. I then created a new carousel template and copied and pasted the points Magic Write generated for me into my template. If you're not confident about starting a carousel template from scratch, you can search for and use any of the beautiful carousel templates available within Canva. Okay, I now need to talk to you about some copyright issues that you really do need to be aware of if you're going to be using AI, such as Magic Write, for commercial purposes. Firstly, you may not have exclusive rights to the content generated by Magic Write. So if you are going to be using that content for the purposes of, say, selling a book, which is written in part by Magic Write, you might need to seek legal advice. You can read more about this on Canva's own website, and I'll leave a link, a handy link, in the description box underneath this video, so do check it out. Next time, I'm going to be showing you how to use Magic Write to create an outline for a Canva presentation and then convert that text to a set of branded slides in Canva in just one click. Meantime, be sure to check out my new YouTube video Shorts, which is coming up in just a second, and I'll show you how to use Canva Magic Write in Canva's mobile app. Thank you so much for your time, and thank you for your interest, and I will see you in the next video.